Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Sharvari and today we are going to start with our new topic, that is transitive verbs with two objects. So first recall, what are transitive verbs? Transitive verbs, the verbs that pass on the actions from doer or subject to object. Means ऐसे verbs जो subject जो action कर रहा है वो pass on करते हैं object. इसका example लिखते हैं, Jane reads a book. Here Jane is subject. Jane is subject. Reads is a verb and book is an object. So note it down. Subject, verb and object. So ये इसका मतलब क्या है? Jane book पढ़ रही है. So Jane reads a book. It makes a sense. So since it is called as transitive verb. Okay. Now let's study about the two different types of transitive verbs. Transitive verbs with two objects. So transitive verbs होते हैं, उनमें दो तरह के object होते हैं. First is a direct object and second one is indirect object. So अब इसका मतलब क्या होता है? Direct objects means name of something and indirect objects means someone to whom something is given. Name of something means किसी का नाम. Indirect object means someone to whom something is given means एक ऐसा व्यक्ति जिसे कुछ तो भी दिया गया है, एक ऐसा particular इंसान जिसे एक particular thing is given. So इसका example देखते हैं. Lara bought her mother a beautiful handbag. So here यहाँ पे जो mother है ये someone to whom something is given means Lara ने अपनी मम्मी के लिए एक ब्यूटीफुल हैंडबैग लाया. किसके लिए लाया? मदर के लिए उसके. तो मदर इज कॉल्ड एज इनडायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट. सो डायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट मींस नेम ऑफ समथिंग एंड हियर हैंडबैग. हैंडबैग, लारा ने अपनी मम्मी के लिए एक हैंडबैग लाया. क्या लाया? हैंडबैग. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज, इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज डायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट. सो नाउ वी विल मूव ऑन टू अवर एक्सरसाइज नंबर एफ. So let's move on to exercise number F. So now moving on to our exercise number F. So what question says is underline the direct objects and circle the indirect objects. Just now we had discussed about direct objects and indirect objects. So now quickly starting the exercise. Urmila gave her mother a packet of chips. So here they are saying underline the direct objects and circle the indirect objects. So here हमने पढ़ा था कि indirect objects means someone to whom something is given. So here her mother is an indirect object. Her mother is a indirect object and a packet of chips is direct objects means name of something. So second one, Geeta promised her cousins ice creams. So here her cousins is indirect objects and ice creams is direct object. Okay, so third one, the customer handed over the money to the shopkeeper. So here handed over the money. Now here आप confused हो सकते हो. Indirect objects means someone to whom something is given and here money is given to the shopkeeper, right? So the shopkeeper will be indirect subject. So here direct object will be the money. Okay, means it is name of something. Now, moving on to fourth one, aunt told us an interesting story. Here also you can confuse because us is indirect object. Okay, an interesting story is direct object. Okay, so now moving on to our next examples. So now, moving on to our next examples. Example number 5 is the poet read out his latest poem to his fans. So here, indirect object is his fans. And the direct object is his latest poem. Okay, so now sixth one. Vinita offered a pastry to the little boy. So a pastry is direct object and the little boy. The little boy is indirect object. So seventh one. The parents bought their daughter toys. So their daughter means indirect object. And direct object is toys. Now, 8-1, Harry gifted a book to his sister. Now, a book is direct object and his sister is indirect object. So, now we will move on to our next topic. So, now moving on to our next topic, that is verbs of incomplete predication. Now, what are verbs of incomplete predication? See here, I have written examples. First example is the girls are. So here it is not making any sense, right? The girls are. The girls hai. Lekin kya hai? Kuch bhi nahi. To ise hum kahenge verb of incomplete predication. Means yahan pe koi bhi compliment nahi hai. Compliment kya? दूसरा सेंटेंस देखो, the girls are delighted. Here it makes a complete sense, right? So here the highlighted word delighted is called as compliment, will be known as compliment. Okay, then there are two types of compliment, subject compliment and again object compliment. See, so yeah, this topic is very easy, so there is no need of explanation more and more. So that's why I will complete it quickly. So the girls are delighted. Here what subject? The girls. R is word. Okay, so here in this sentence, delighted. The word delighted is describing the girls. Means girls kaisi hai? Delighted. The girls are delighted. So they are called as subject compliment. The word delighted will be called as subject compliment. Because it is describing the subject, the girls. Okay. Now object compliment. We found this book helpful. Now, we is subject here. Found is word. And this book is object. Right. So, here, object compliment means what? The compliment which describes the object. Here, compliment is helpful. Helpful is describing the object, which is this book. Means we found this book helpful. हमें ये book helpful लगी. Helpful क्या लगी? Book. So, and the book, this book is object. So, that's why the word helpful is object compliment. So, now we'll come to our exercise G. That's the last exercise of this chapter. So, now moving on to our question number G. Underline the complements in these sentences and write whether they are subject complements in bracket SC or object complements in bracket OC. So here we have to identify whether these complements are subject complements or object complements. So let's identify that. The audience deemed the performance outstanding. Here, outstanding is compliment, of course. Here, it is an object compliment. Okay, because the audience deemed the performance outstanding and performance is object. and outstanding is continuing. So, object continuing. Okay. Then second, the players nominated Naveen captain. So here, captain is complement. And which type of complement? Object complement. Because Naveen is here means object. Right. Now, the tiger seems ferocious. Ferocious. So here, this complement and the type of complement is SC. Subject complement. Because the tiger is subject and ferocious is complement. Okay, so now let's move on to our remaining examples. So now coming to example number 4. Your parcel seems ready. So here, ready is complement and it is subject complement. Now, fifth one. We found this book helpful. So, I have told you the answer and now it's a homework question for you. Six. The information you received is authentic. So, here it is subject complement. And what's the complement? Authentic. So now, आपको मुझे एक कमेंट में बताना है कि फिफ्थ का आंसर क्या है. And also, I have described this one and मैंने आंसर भी बता दिया है explanation में. Okay, so moving on to our 7th and 8th example. So, here Roger is compliment. So, here don't get confused because the Varun named their dog Roger. Means, kya naam diya unhone? Roger. So, it will be object compliment. And again, 8. Mother was shocked to see Meeta shivering. So here, shivering is compliment and it is object compliment. Okay, so now let's move on to our next topic. So now, we will do the summary of this chapter. So what we have learned in this chapter is, we learned about verbs. Yeah, of course the chapter name is verbs. So we have learned about verbs. The verb is a word which refers to an action, event or state. And regular verbs and irregular verbs. Right, regular verbs which follow a set pattern while changing their forms. And irregular verbs means which do not follow a pattern while changing their forms. Okay. So then troublesome verbs means confusing words means there are same words with same means pronunciation but their meanings are different. Okay. Formation of verbs means we can form verbs by adding suffixes and prefixes. Then uses of be, do and have we have learnt. You can find the video in description box or otherwise you can go to my channel and find the video. And transitive and intransitive verbs, just now we have discussed. And transitive verbs with two objects and the two objects are direct object and indirect object. Now, verbs of incomplete predication. Okay? So, which do not make a complete sense. And in that we have learned about complements also, subject complement and object complement. So, ye summary इसलिए ली गई थी कि आप जो भी इस टॉपिक ये जो भी टॉपिक आपने चैप्टर नंबर 5 में पढ़े हैं वो आप भूले ना. So here ends the chapter and we'll meet again with the new chapter. Till then take care and bye bye.